The world is changing, and so do the accounting treatments of various aspects. Hello everyone, my name is Ajmer Din, and today I'm talking about one of the greatest changes of the revenue recognition policy of the entities. Yes, I'm talking about IFRS 15, and in the Indian context, Ind AS 115. Both are the same in my opinion. So before I start, if you wish to have this video in your own language, just check the subtitle option below. Select your language, and if you do not find your language of interest, just let me know. I will make sure to update it for you. If you want this presentation in a printable format, just also leave your comment for the same in the comment box. So let us begin with it. The core principle of the standard is an entity recognize its revenue to show the transfer of promised goods or services to the customer in an amount that reflects the consideration and to which the entity expects to be get entitled in exchange of those goods and services. The standards have broken down the entire recognition criteria into 5 simple steps. So before that, just brief this out. There should be a transfer of promised goods and services, there should be an amount, and there should be an exchange. So the standard has broken down the entire recognition criteria into 5 simple steps. So these are those 5 steps. They're very simple, and it will help a lot to the entities while recognizing any of the contract. Number 1, identify the contracts with the customer. This is very important. A contract is an agreement between two or more parties that creates enforceable rights and obligations. The standard requires to identify those contracts. It can be verbal or in written. Step number 2, identify the performance obligation in the contract. A contract includes many promises like transfer of goods and services to the customer, in exchange of money, in exchange of monetary, non-monetary item. If those are distinct goods and services, the promise are performance obligation and they are accounted for separately. Step number 3, determine the transaction price. Transaction price, in a very simple term, it's a money. Okay, the transaction price is an amount of consideration in the contract to which an entity expects to get entitled in exchange of goods or services. Price can be fixed, can be variable, can be a mixture of monetary and non-monetary items. Step number 4, allocate the transaction price to the performance obligation. This is very important aspect. What you all need to do, generally what happens, entity allocates the transaction price to each and every performance obligation on the basis of relative standalone selling price. If there is a contract having 2 obligation, one is goods, transfer of goods, and one is transfer of service, so they are separately identifiable, then selling price is allocated to both of them. Okay, so however, when selling price or the transaction price of standalone selling price is not observable, then entity needs to estimate it. Step number 5, recognize revenue when or as the entity satisfied those performance obligations. Okay, the amount of revenue recognized is the amount of allocated to the satisfied performance obligation. You need to tick mark each and every obligation as and when they comes to satisfy. For obligations or the performance obligation, if they are satisfied over the period of time, an entity recognizes the revenue over the time by selecting appropriate method of measuring the entity's progress. For example, it happens in a construction contract. So these were the 5 steps. Let me illustrate it for you with an example. And this is very interesting example of Mr. John and Miss LA. So what happens? Mr. John used to sell computer and used to service the computers, and Miss LA wants to buy a computer, a personal desktop for her. So she approached Mr. John and says, okay Mr. John, I want to have a computer. Mr. John gave her an offer that she can purchase a service card which she can utilize those service card after 1 year of service, after 1 year of purchase. So Miss Elena agreed to pay $100 for the computer and $5 for the service card, so total $105. Mr. John promised to give the computer and services, and Miss Elena paid the amount. So here the contract is present in the form of verbal communication between Mr. John, who is selling the computer and service card for $105. So now let me break down this illustration into 5 steps. And step number 1, what is performance obligation? First of all, whether there is contract or not, yes, there is a contract which is present between both of them in a verbal way. Step number 2, whether there is performance obligation or not, yes, it is an performance obligation to Mr. John for transferring those computer and services. It's an obligation for him. Step number 3, what is the transaction price? Transaction price here is $105. So now we need to allocate such transaction price into performance obligation. So performance obligation number 1 is transfer of computer, which is for $100, and obligation number 2 is giving service card, which can be utilized after 1 year, which is performance obligation number 2, which considers transfer transaction price of $5. So I have break down $100 for computer and $5 for service after 1 year. Now we need to recognize the revenue. So number 1, $100 will be recognized as and when the computer is transferred, and number 2, the service amount will be recognized as and when the service has been performed, and this is referred in para number 35 of the both of the standards. So I hope you understood the illustration. If you have any kind of doubt regarding this presentation, just let me know in the comment box of this video. Thanks for watching, and thank you very, very much for having keen interest on the video. Queries are always welcome. So in the next video, what I'm going to share in detail step number 1, which was identifying of contracts as per IFRS 15 and Ind AS 115, both are same. So in the next video, I'm going to talk about first and initial step of identifying the contract in detail. Thank you very much for watching once again.